think I've sent you alone. I sent your brother, Eric, with you. You want to turn with me? Moses said, Wow. Well, I've never done it before me. Okay. I'm happy to do it for you now. And then, Aaron and Moses together went to the king. Moses didn't need to talk to his brothers there. It just looked so sweet. How many people know that story? You know that story, yeah, Lord, but I know that story. All of them. I praise you for that. Now, verse 2. God made Jesus a high priest. And Jesus was faithful to God. Same as Moses was. Jesus did everything that God wanted him to do in God's house. Verse 3. Now, example, when someone builds a house, people are going to honor the builder more than the house. And that's right. He had to figure it out, do all the measurements and everything, and build it from those. It's strong, it's good, it's not going to collapse. Easy. Steel, good foundation. Now, Jesus should have more honor than Moses. That example of a house built by somebody, but God built a good thing. That's it. Now, verse 5. Moses, he was faithful like a servant in God's whole house. Told the people what God would say in the future. Verse 6. But Christ, he's faithful in ruling and being in control of God's house as the Son. And we are God's house. If we remain confident of the great hope that we are happy to say we have. Yeah. That's a good one. established it. They're going to work in all these different issues. Moses, what are you doing it for? Why are we doing all these different things? Moses said, because you're complaining. Finish the complaint. I warn you. You're a Russian. Don't live like that. That's enough. And snakes will come in and get you. Kill you. Jesus said, but look at your stuff. If you go back, didn't listen, didn't pay attention. If you follow Moses correctly, we are so blessed compared to those people back at that time. Then Jewish people will cry, oh, I'm first, I'm first. God looked at them and said, don't worry. I'm open it wide open to the Gentiles and the Jews together to accept the Son. See, it says, for 40 years in the desert, your people, I've got to see what I did. But even after you said what I did, they tested me. And my patience. God does a lot today. You need to do what I say. Don't test me. He's God. We're so blessed as men to be here, come, be patient, come, study. Fellowship, worship to God. Verse 10 says, God, God was angry with them. And I said, their thoughts, they seem to be always wrong. They're always wrong. They never have understood my ways. Perfect application for us today. Imagine, many people in the world are out there. They just don't care about God's church, about God's house, about God's book, about God's helper. You get the thing. Imagine. Oh, they say, church, they're not welcoming God. Really, we're dead people. Oh, really? Why not all the churches follow God's word? Why don't all the churches do that? Verse 13. But I want you to encourage each other every day or daily while you still have something that's named death. Help each other so that none of you will be fooled by sin. Verse 14. You know, we have the honor of sharing in all that Christ has. If we will just continue until the end, we have that sure faith that we have in the end. See, it said so what it said. You need to be consistent, faithful, patient. Thankful, helpful, encouraging, working together. Supporting each other. Even though you may say, hey, right? But, amen. Verse 15. Now that's why. But the Spirit. Spirit says, if you hear God's voice, get it together. Yeah. Don't keep studying. Book of Psalms, 95, 7, 8. Verse 16. Who knows? Who listened or heard God's voice and turned against him? Father,